One woman for 100 soldiers and one for 50 officers. The whole truth about brothels for German soldiers. The military command of the Third Reich approached the issue of the intimate needs of Wehrmacht soldiers and officers with characteristic German thoroughness. In the 19th century, brothels were considered commonplace in Western society, and visiting them was not frowned upon. Men were used to the availability of such services and did not want to give up established habits. The leadership of the Wehrmacht soberly assessed the situation and did not seek moral re-education of personnel or suppression of natural needs. Instead, it was decided to streamline this area, taking it under strict control. This approach allowed us to solve several important tasks at once. An organized system of intimate services helped to maintain the morale of the troops, prevent unwanted contacts with the local population, and reduce the risk of the spread of sexually transmitted diseases. In addition, it made it possible to control the leisure time of military personnel and minimize potential problems associated with the unorganized search for such services. The military command of the Third Reich also took into account the fact that wars are often accompanied by an upsurge in violence by victorious armies against civilians, especially women. Such a reputation did not fit into the image of the Wehrmacht as the bearer of the new just order. Drastic measures have been taken to solve this delicate problem. For the first time in world history, a special ministry was created under the military department, which actually legalized the oldest profession at the state level. All women who provided intimate services to military personnel automatically received the status equated to civil servants of this ministry. This approach not only streamlined this area but also allowed for strict control over it. Women who worked in this system received official salaries, insurance, and various benefits. Surprisingly, there were many ideological young German women among them who considered their work an important contribution to the victory of the Reich. The effectiveness of this ministry was confirmed by the fact that in the first 2 years of the war, almost every military unit had its own mobile brothel, which followed it everywhere. Franz Halder's famous statement that the brothels could not keep up with the advancing units was more evidence of the rapidity of the Blitzkrieg than of the shortcomings of the system. German pedantry has also manifested itself in this area. Everything was strictly regulated, including the number of military personnel per employee. Spontaneous visits by soldiers or the girls' arbitrary work schedule were excluded. The instructions described in detail the procedure for the provision of services, taking into account the differences between officers and enlisted men. The standards were based on serious, scientific calculations and not on arbitrary decisions. This approach reflected the general trend towards strict organization in all aspects of army life in the Third Reich. In the intimate service system of the Wehrmacht, as in other areas of military life, there were clear norms and categorization. The brothels were divided into three classes: for soldiers, non-commissioned officers, and officers. The standards of service varied depending on the rank. One employee per 100 soldiers, 75 non-commissioned officers, or 50 officers. Luftwaffe soldiers had special privileges. Even ground staff were served at the officer level, 1 to 50. And for pilots, the norm was one woman per 20 people. The level of service also differed. Before receiving a Luftwaffe officer, the employee had to take a bath and meet the client fully dressed and with makeup. The bed linen was changed after each visit. In the soldiers' brothels, conditions were simpler. The workers were waiting for customers already in bed, and the linen was changed after every 10th visitor. Considering that each serviceman was entitled to 5 to 6 visits per month, it is not difficult to calculate the monthly workload per employee. It ranged from 600 people in soldiers' brothels to 60 in Luftwaffe establishments. Officers' brothels were distinguished by a higher level of service and strict staff selection. Only ethnic German women with impeccable manners and typical Aryan appearance were accepted there. Tall blondes with blue or grey eyes. In other institutions, the requirements were less strict, but blood purity remained an important criterion. The observance of racial standards was monitored by a specially created department of the ethnic community and health of the Gestapo. However, as the military operations expanded, these requirements were gradually relaxed. The procedure for visiting the brothel was strictly regulated. Surprisingly, it took 45 minutes to complete the necessary documents. Each soldier received 5 to 6 monthly vouchers to visit a brothel. These coupons have acquired the status of a kind of currency in the army environment. They could be deprived as a punishment, or conversely, given an additional reward. Soldiers who were not interested in using coupons for their intended purpose could exchange them for cigarettes, schnapps, or chocolate. Despite the intensive work schedule, strict sanitary standards were maintained in the brothels of the Wehrmacht. The workers underwent almost daily medical examinations, which made it possible to minimize the risks of spreading diseases. The procedure for visiting the brothel was carefully regulated. Of the allotted hour, only 15 minutes were allocated directly for intimate contact. The remaining 45 minutes were distributed among various formalities: registration of a coupon with presentation of a soldier's book, medical examination of the visitor, mandatory hygiene procedures. After the visit, the spine of the registered coupon was handed over to the office of the unit. Such an accounting system made it possible, in case of infection, to quickly identify the source of infection and prevent its further spread. Where did the girls come from? The Second World War began on September 1, 1939, with the attack on Poland. Already on September 9, Interior Minister Wilhelm Frick signed a decree on the establishment of brothels in the occupied territories. Poland became the first country where this system was tested. The practice quickly spread to other captured countries. In Western Europe, the organization of such establishments has not caused serious difficulties. In France and the Netherlands, there was already a developed industry of intimate services with an established registration system. The Nazis had only to expand the existing infrastructure a little. Moreover, the Nazis, obsessed with the idea of the purity of the Aryan race, considered, for example, the Dutch to be a kindred people. The situation changed dramatically after the invasion of the USSR. Here, the Nazis faced two problems: the lack of any organized structure for such services, and an ideological contradiction, since the Slavs were considered non-Aryan peoples. For contacting them, the soldiers were threatened with punishment. To resolve this contradiction, the Nazis adopted double standards. If unregulated relationships, including violent acts, were prosecuted, then contacts with Slavic women were allowed and considered permissible in official brothels. One of the main sources of personnel for the Wehrmacht brothels was the association Faith and Beauty. Many of the girls from there were true fanatics of Nazi ideology. However, the principle of staffing these institutions has changed significantly in the USSR. Unlike in Europe, where women often volunteered for such work, such cases were rare in the Soviet Union. The shortage of staff was made up by forced methods. The mildest option was to choose between deportation to Germany and working in a brothel. However, the Nazis did not disdain direct raids on young women. In these cases, the racial issue receded into the background and attractive appearance became the main criterion. The system of coercion and violence reached its apogee in the concentration camps. Similar establishments were also created there. According to some reports, about 5,000 young women were sent to army brothels from Ravensbrück alone. These women were completely disenfranchised. There were no regulations for them, and in case of illness, they were most often simply shot. Friends, subscribe to the channel, like it, and write your comments. Thank you all for watching.